Hosanna, praise. One thing we ask of you, one thing that we desire, that as we worship you, Lord, come and change our lives. Arise, 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 take your place, be enthroned on our praise. King of kings, holy God, as we sing, arise, 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 arise. One thing we ask of you,
indeed. Arise, 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 as we arise for yet a new day, a next day that God has given us. We arise to give him praise, to thank him, to acknowledge him as God this morning. Father, we bless you, we thank you, and we praise you for this great privilege of life in the land of the living. Father, help us to understand what you're doing in this time and this season, Lord Jesus, that we are going to be right with you, Lord Jesus. We thank you for this day you have given us. We don't take it for granted. It was never promised to us, God, but it was granted to us today. Many didn't awake this morning, Father, but we are alive in the land of the living. Let your will be done in our life. Thank you for this great privilege. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for waking us, Father. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Help us to be fruitful, God. Help us to be fruitful. Help us to be mindful of the souls that are lost and going to hell without hearing from you, Father, hearing about you, God, the great plan of salvation, Father. And those who have received you, Lord, help us to be serious about it, that we can do great exploits for the kingdom of heaven. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Have your way, Father.
Lord, come and inhabit the praises of your people. How many of God's people do we have out there tonight? Sing this with me.
We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises.
Yeah.
We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises.
Come on.
We lift you up, we lift you up, we lift you up on our praises.
Yeah.
We lift you up, we lift you up.
God, my God. Come on, brethren. Let's do it one more time. Arise. Glory to God. And take your place this morning. Glory to God. My God. man, indeed. Indescribable, man. Hey, glory to God. 18 minutes on the other side of 7 o'clock. We greet you in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus as we just thank God for our life this morning. And we thank God for the lives of our brothers and sisters and everyone that's under the sound of my voice this morning. We bless God. We are thankful. We are grateful for a new day in the land of the living. Regardless to what you feel on the outside, regardless to what you're going through, Jesus Christ is Lord. Glory to God. You have life. You got hope. A new day is ahead of you. Let's continue to give God praise, the one who makes everything possible. We bless God. It's called Arise right here on Choice Radio. Good morning to you.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my all in all. Seeking you as a precious jewel, Lord, to give up I'd be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name.
Sing again, I bless your name. You are my all in all.
When I fall down, you pick me up. When I am dry, you fill my cup. You are my all in all.
Jesus,
after 7 o'clock, it's Arise. Good morning, good morning. Ado's getting there for 7:30. You gotta keep moving, keep moving. The time waits for no man, woman, boy, or girl. All right, if you get in there, you gotta just keep getting there. Amen. We right here with you. Move along, move along. Amen. Do what gotta be done in the name of the Lord. Yes, indeed. All those on the phone lines, good morning to you. 641-793-0192. All those on the app, good morning. Choice Gospel Radio. Go to your market and download the app, whatever platform, and share it. We bless God this morning. All those on the website, good morning to you. www.choicegospelnetwork.com. Glory to God. All those on 92, good morning to you, wherever you're listening. As we humble before you one more day, to lift up the name that is above every name. That name is Jesus. Glory to God this morning. We bless His name this morning.
Whisper His name, whisper His name, and He will answer you. Whisper His name, whisper His name, whisper His name, and He will come to you. Call out His name. Call out His name. Call out His name. And He will come to you. Call out His name. Call out His name. Call out His name. And He will come to you. Our hands to you and say, you're all we need. You're all we need.
Hallelujah.
You're all we need. Glory to you in the highest place. 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 Glory to you in the highest.
Are you afraid to shout the name this morning? My God. My God. 29 minutes past 7 o'clock. As we bless God this morning. Come on! You're washed in the blood of the Lamb this morning. Shout out the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Let that devil know your mind is made up. Glory to God this morning, right here, Choice Radio. It's called Arise. Wake up, brothers and sisters. Come on, let's do this thing. Let's worship the Most High. Let's worship the King of Kings, the one who have called us from darkness. Come on, get up this morning. My God. My God,
He'll run to you.
Yes, He'll run to you. Glory to God this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Indeed, He will run to you. 30 minutes exactly after the hour, man. Glory to God. Listen to this, Choice Radio. We bless God for Jesus. And I'm telling you, man, it's just a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful testimony of the Lord, what He can do for us to take us away from this world. Glory to God. And not have the world have us under subjection. You know what I mean? We no longer walk according to the course of this world. This is a beautiful thing, brethren. This is a beautiful thing. So we bless God this morning for what He has done in our life. And those of you who have seen the maturity of that in your life come to pass, that God has called you from darkness into His marvelous light. Let's bless the King this morning. The word of God declares in Isaiah 61, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord had anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He had sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and to opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God. Amen. To comfort all that mourn, to appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called trees of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that He might be glorified. And they shall build the old ways, they shall rise up the former desolations, and they shall repair the waste cities and desolations of many generations. Glory to God. And strangers shall stand and feed your flocks, and the sons of the alien shall be your plowsmen and your vine dressers. Glory to God. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus this morning. Glory to God. And that's what it's all about, the believer in Jesus. As you step out this morning, you are no longer consumed by the world. The world don't have you on a leash. Glory to God. All of you stepping out this morning, glory to God, knowing that we have overcome the world. Glory to God. Let's give God praise this morning for this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful testimony in our life. As you step out this morning, whatever struggle, whatever situation it is, Jesus Christ have brought us something different from what we knew in time past. Let's bless Him this morning.
Oh.
tonight. Jesus saves. Free at last, what a joyful noise we'll make as we join with heaven's song to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. We'll sing it out to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. You save, you heal, restore, reveal your Father's heart to us. You rose to raise us from the grave. Your Spirit lives in us. Sing it out to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. To let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Jesus saves. Raise a shout.
Raise a shout this morning, brethren. You gotta walk in this new anointing. If you are born again, you have to walk in it. It don't just come on like that. You gotta walk in the newness. If you're born again, be born again. And see Jesus. Set you afire. Set you apart from the world. Glory to God.
To let all the world know that Jesus saves. Shout it out. To let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout. To let all the world know that Jesus saves. Sing it out. To let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout. To let all the world know that Jesus saves. Sing it out. Shout till the whole world knows his name.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Jesus saves this morning, brethren. You got to put on that new man. Glory to God. Glory to God. Let's turn to the scriptures. Glory to God. We bless God indeed. Glory to God. And once you put on that new man, that devil, trust me, he gonna tempt you and test you, but you gotta put on the new man. That's why we encourage the body of Christ. You are born again believer. You have to walk in the newness. Trust me. You gotta put it on. If you bought you a new coat and it's cold, if you don't put it on, how could you feel warm? Glory to God. Ephesians 4:21. Hallelujah. If so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus, that ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit and your mind, and that ye put on the new man which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Glory to God. Wherefore putting away lying, speaking every man truth with his neighbor. Glory to God. For we are members of one of another. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God, brethren. Listen, man, that's what it's all about. Let's do it one more time. Jesus saves. My God. It's called Arise on the Choice Radio. Glory to God this morning. Amen. Put on the new man. Come on. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you're born again, you're born again. Let us walk in the newness this morning, brethren. Trust me. And watch God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. My God.
Hope is here. Shout the news to everyone. It's a new day. Peace has come.
the storms of life. Sing it through the darkest nights. Jesus saves. Free at last, what a joyful noise we'll make as we join with heaven's song to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. We'll sing it out to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. You save, you heal, restore, reveal your Father's heart to us. You rose to raise us from the grave. Your Spirit lives in us. Sing it out to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Shout it out to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Raise a shout to let all the world know that Jesus saves. Sing it out.
There's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. If you feel lost, he's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a prison shaking savior. If you got chains, he's a chain breaker. We've all searched for the light of day in the dead of night. We've all found ourselves worn out from the same old fight. And we've all run to things we know just ain't right. And there's a better life. There's a better life. If you got pain, he's a pain taker. He's a way maker. If you need freedom, a savior, he's a present shaking savior. You got chains, well, he's a chain breaker. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify, testify. If you believe it, if you receive it, if you can feel it, somebody testify. If you feel lost, I need a way maker.
Bless God this morning.
Freedom.
45 minutes past the 7. Morning to each and everyone. It's called Arise. Right here on Joyce Radio. It's your life. It's your salvation. It's your choice. And Jesus Christ is Lord of the signal. Glory to God this morning. All the believers in Jesus. It's Abraham morning. My wife, good morning. My God, glory to God. My God. Indeed. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. All the taxi drivers, good morning to you. Bless God. My God, my God. Glory to God. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We just bless God for Jesus this morning. And as we have just quoted that scripture here from Ephesians 4. And it's very important for the body of Christ to understand that the devil is real. And the devil will test you to see if you are brave and bold to step into your new identity in Christ Jesus. Very important. Amen. Those closest around you will tempt you and test you. Put it on if you're bad. Let me see if you change. Let me see if you... Glory to God, but you got to put it on. Trust me, trust me, trust me. We need men and women to put on that new man that we could all be on one accord for the Lord and his business. Glory to God. Souls for the kingdom of heaven. Put on that new man in Christ. Let's do it again, Ephesians 4:20. Hallelujah. But ye have not so learned Christ. You have not so learned Christ. Glory to God. You have not learned Christ. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus, that ye put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, glory to God, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that ye put on the new man, hallelujah, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Glory to God. Wherefore, glory to God, putting away lying, speaking every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. Be angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath, neither give place to the devil. Glory to God. Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands. Glory to God, the thing which is good, that he may have to give to him that needeth. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers. Glory to God, and grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby ye are sealed until the day of redemption. Glory to God. Bless God indeed. So the church of Jesus Christ need to put on that new man. Glory to God. Glory to God. But we have to be bold to walk into that new man. Glory to God. And I encourage you, maybe somebody today, you're on your job or wherever you are, glory to God, everybody else around you is profane and going on in the best of they know. We must put on that new man and step into that jacket of holiness. We must step in and declare that God is God. Hallelujah. Only then you can be covered, glory to God, from the snares of the devil. And you will have an opportunity to bring those in darkness into light. But you must put on your garment, glory to God, that you can save those around you. Glory to God. So if everybody's drowned in, you got to put on yours first. You know they say on the plane, right? Make sure you put on yours first. You put the thing behind your neck. You pull it over your head. And you breathe in. Amen. Glory to God. And then you can go help somebody else. Amen. So we need to put on the new man. Glory to God. It's a rise in the morning. But we bless God. My friend, I'm playing that one for you this morning. Brother Earl, I'm playing that one for you this morning. And my good friend, how you doing? I'll play that for you. Amen. Glory to God. It's 10 more minutes to the top of the hour, man. It's Jesus Christ is Lord on Choice Radio. And those of you that are born again, we bless God for Jesus. Those who understand, you know what I mean, what is really happening, we bless God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you get in there for 8, you got to keep moving. Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God. Wake up with a new attitude this morning. Let's live for the King. Amen. Who has believed our report? My God, who has believed it? My God, my God, my God. All taxi drivers, good morning to you. Brother Nelson, morning. Brother Edwin, and all the young men. Everybody on Choice Radio, good morning to you. Amen. Glory to God, everybody. Every minister, glory to God. Every pastor out there in Radio Land, glory to God. Amen. Jesus Christ is Lord. Get the church activated for souls. Hallelujah. My God. Bruce's family, good morning to you.
Jesus, he has given me victory.
Sister Yvonne, morning. My God.
He has given me victory. Oh. All the days of my life I praise you. Everything that I have now you give to me, Baba. Lord, I say for your love I'm grateful. Yes, you love me plenty, you came to die for me. Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Nissi, I am that I am. Ooh. Oh, I search around, there's no one else like you. Lord, you love Judah, Judah, man, man, man.
My God, glory to God this morning. We're walking in the newness of life. Hallelujah! Glory to God. Somebody scream for Jesus. Hallelujah! Let people talk. Let them say what they want. God has given us liberty. Walk in the newness, brethren. Declare the works of the Lord. Come on, brethren. My God. My God, my God.
God has given me victory.
God has given me victory.
He has given me victory.
Hallelujah.
God.
He has taken away my sorrows and now I'm free.
Aiden, good morning.
I got me, hallelujah.
Doctor, good morning to you. How are you?
I got my hallelujah.
Miss River Sally, good morning.
Because of Jesus, every day now shagara.
My God, my God.
Double, double, heavenly blessed.
Miss Jackman, good morning. See. Hallelujah.
Ah, yeah.
Hey.
God, your grace and mercy is always to follow me.
My God.
He has given me victory.
Those walking in purity before Holy God. Somebody scream, my God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Tandy Pad, good morning. Sister Carol, good morning to you. All the family. My God, my God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's give you victory. Come, let's dance. Let's give him praises now. If Jesus has given you victory, come, let's dance. Let's give him praises now. Because of Jesus,
every miracle morning.
Double, double, heavenly blessing that he might receive. Ah, yeah. God, your grace and mercy is always the follow.
Yeah.
He has given me victory.
And your beautiful sister. 5 more minutes to the top of the hour.
He has given me victory.
My God.
He has given me victory.
Hallelujah.
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 day that Shagara had a do. Double, double, heavenly blessings that he might receive. God, your grace and mercy is always to follow me.
My goodness gracious, amen. We bless God this morning. Brethren, when we are able to overcome the world, glory to God, hallelujah. It's something to rejoice about when we are walking and we are striving to walk them and seek the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. Then we can jump, because the devil have no victory when we are shouting and dancing in Christ, walking in holiness. Glory to God. So we bless God for Jesus this morning and all those who are striving to enter in at the narrow gate. Let's continue to strive to enter in at the narrow gate. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. 4 more minutes to the top of the hour. We bless God this morning. It is Choice Radio. And we have quoted this year from Ephesians 4. And it's very important for the body of Christ to understand that we have an adversary that doesn't want you to ever come near to that cloak of righteousness to put it on. But we must put it on. If we want to see God, we want to see the power of God, we want to have that liberty in Christ Jesus, we must put on the new man. And the Church of Jesus Christ must teach this. We have to put it on. Because the point about it is, the devil knows the difference. But we have to strive to the mark of the high calling. So if God has required us to walk in a new way, we have to put it on. You have to do it. Amen. To enter in to that realm. Glory to God. That we can see the power of God. We must do it. We must try it on. Glory to God. So the scripture is saying to put on that new man. Let the new man come on. Glory to God. Because everywhere you go and every day, you will find somebody contesting you. Don't put on that. What you think you are? Who you think you are? Who you think you miss holy? Oh, you think you're brother holy? What you think it is? Oh, you think you're better than somebody? Oh, yeah. That's the devil himself. Glory to God. But God said to put it on. Glory to God. Let's read it again. Ephesians 4. Glory to God. He said, but ye have not so learned Christ. You have not learned Christ. Hallelujah. If so be, ye have heard him. Glory to God. And have been taught by him. As the truth is in Jesus, that he put off concerning the former conversation, the old man which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that he put on the new man which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. So we must put on that new man that we can declare the glory of God and experience the works of God. But of course you will be contested, because in your flesh, if somebody say you're playing this and you're playing that, you have a tendency to say, well, let me just take it a little easy. Maybe I'm going out of the character. But that's what we do when we get born again. We go out of character. When you are born again, you are out of character of the world. We are no longer of this world. We go out of character. Glory to God. Amen. So whenever you go on your job, wherever, let them know you are child of the King. You are child of Jesus. And brethren, you know, I'm just sitting here and the Lord is putting this thing in my spirit. You know, brethren, people understand the power and the aura of God. People know it. They know it and they want it. If you have it, they want it. They don't want you to hide it. You bring it out. Bring out Christ. Bring out the love of God. Bring out the love of God. Let people know that your God is real. Don't listen to the corrupt talk and the foolishness. Don't partake in this stuff. No. No, we can't do that, brethren. Glory to God. We bring a shame and disgrace to the name of our Lord. Glory to God. So we must put on the new man. If we are truly born again, we must put on the new man. Glory to God. And this is not saying that somebody not born again. But if you are, then put on the new man. If you have learned Christ, put it on. Don't be afraid to practice holiness according to 2 Corinthians 7. We must practice holiness. For who? In the fear of God. Not man. Not man, in the fear of God. Because we have these great promises, we put on the new man. Glory to God. And then the people will always try to contest you. Don't care where you go. Don't care who you are. If you're a child of God, people will confront you. The devil going to use family members, husbands, wife, children, to confront you. Who you think you are? Will you come out? What's going on with you? What you think you're holy? You think you... Yes, they will. The devil could use any one of them. Your pastor too, we could use him to confront you. Who you think you are? You just came into this thing. We've been here for donkey years, tell him yes. And put on the new man and glory to God. Oh man, this is beautiful. We bless God. My God, exactly 8 o'clock. My God, put on the new man this morning. A brand new one from Miss Glacier Robinson. Hope you're in a good mood this morning, brethren.
Lord, I declare I will praise you until I die.
Talk to me now.
You've been my help. I know that you hear me when I cry. Lord, you are great. You're mighty on you. I can depend. My rock, my strength, my refuge, my forever friend. I lift my hands and I give you the praise.
It's the island morning.
I lift my hands.
The blue family.
Give you the praise.
My God, for a Claude.
It's
the Paulet morning.
It's
the Ruder morning.
Lord, we declare there is no God like you.
Talk to me now.
Most high, most holy one, you are faithful and ever true. Lord, you are great, you're mighty, on you we can depend. Oh, rock our strength, a refuge, our forever friend.
God.
Emmanuel, El Elyon, the God Most High.
Put on the new man today. The world is dying. Sinners are crying. Let us represent the Most High. Glory to God.
And with my voice, this song I rise. I praise you all my
doing it one more time indeed as you step inside the jump. As we open the phone lines for you, it's Choice Radio, your life, your salvation, your choice. Let's take it one more time. Miss S, good morning.
Lord, I declare I will praise you until I die.
Praise him on your job. Let them know you are born again. My God.
Lord, you are great. You're mighty, on you I can depend. My rock, my strength, my rest.
Sister Roy, morning to you. Sister Xavier, morning. Sister Sancho, morning.
I give you the praise.
Sister Belfort, morning to you. Sister Eslin, morning.
This song I rise. I praise you all my days. Lord, we declare there is no God like you. Most high, most holy one, you are faithful and ever true. Lord, you are great. You're mighty, on you we can depend. Oh, rock our strength. I lift my hands and I give you the praise. And with my voice, this song I rise.
WJ, good morning to you, sir. All the family on the front line with Choice Radio, we bless God for you. Yes. All those that is praying for us, keep praying for us. We bless God, we do right to us, bless God indeed. Hallelujah. Let's be bold for Jesus today. My God. The phone is open. 347-663-8638. Something on your mind this morning? Open forum this morning. Who will go for us?
With everything within me, I declare your glory. You are God, holy and righteous. You are God.
Open forum this morning, right here on the Choice Radio. Good morning to you, everybody. As we greet you in the mighty name of Jesus, and as you hear the team this morning, really, let us live for Jesus. Let's put on holiness if we have it. Glory to God.
Holy and right.
Let us live it if we have it. Yeah. Let us see it. Let us hear it if you got it. Good morning to you, you. Hey, brother Tony, morning to you, man. Long time, yeah. Hey, Roy Rogers, good morning to you, sir. Take that caller on the air. Caller, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Bless God. Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes, you're live. Good morning to you. Bless God.
Yes. This has been on my mind for a long time. I just want everyone to join in, the people that are listening. We all need to pray for Haiti. It's been on my mind. Every time I pray, I always ask God to let someone else pray with me. That we pray for that country, that nation, to get out under the curse of that witchcraft and voodoo. So people could come to Christ, so the children don't have to fall into that demonic spirit. So at least they could stand a chance to come to Jesus. Thank you.
All right. Definitely, indeed. Thank you for that call. Thank you for that call. You say, well, pray for Haiti. Indeed. Well, glory to God. Well, we have to pray for every place under the face of the sun that has the same voodoo and thing going on there. So we know probably that's a place people talk about as you know, that's a sort of capital. If somebody say Haiti, people first thing they come on is voodoo. If you talk about reggae music, they talk about Jamaica. If you talk about calypso or steel band, they talk about Trinidad. But in the reality of it, man, all over the world right now, trust me, all over the world right now, it's so much going on in the darkness all over the world, my brother. Trust me, all over the world right now, it's so much of this kind of stuff. All over through the Caribbean right now, all over, trust me. You don't, I mean, I'm telling you, man. So we bless God. Thank you for the call this morning, and it's on your heart to pray for Haiti. Amen. Glory to God. So we bless God. And we, Father, we just thank you for Haiti today in the name of Jesus, and we pray that you will send workers in the field, Almighty God, to proclaim your gospel with power and authority, with signs following, that the people don't need to look to any other God but to look to you, Father. So we pray for laborers in the field in Haiti to be anointed with the power, hallelujah, with signs, glory to God, that the men and women who involve in that contrary way, God, will come and accept your power and use your power to do what they need to do, Father. So we pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that your will be done. Somebody listening, whoever it is, hallelujah, is going to intervene, hallelujah, and let the power of the Most High be experienced by the people down there in Haiti. Glory to God. So we bless God for you, my brother, this morning for that call here. And what makes the difference as you call and you make this here? Let's take a look in the scripture and look at something here concerning Jesus Christ and concerning what's make different and how difference happen in life. Let's look at the scriptures and see what the Lord is going to say to us in that scripture here. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's turn to the book of Acts. Glory to God, and take something here. We're going to look at something here in the word of God. Bless God. Father, we bless you and we thank you for your children out there in Radio Land. Glory to God. And this morning we were talking about putting on the new man. Putting on the new man. The Bible says signs will follow them that believe. Glory to God. And how important it is that we who are born again truly step out to do exploits for the Lord, that he can anoint us to make a difference. Glory to God. In Acts 8 and 9. But there was a certain man called Simon, which before time in the city used sorcery and bewitched the people of Samaria, giving out that himself was some great one, to whom they all gave heed, from the least to the greatest, saying, this man is the great power of God. Hallelujah. And to him they had regard, because that of a long time he had bewitched them with sorceries. But when they believed Philip's preaching, the things concerning the kingdom of God and the name of Jesus Christ, they were baptized, both men and women. Then Simon himself believed also. And when he was baptized, he continued with Philip and wondered, beholding the miracles and signs which were done. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. So don't care who we are, if we express the love of Christ and we express the love and honesty of God as followers of Jesus, don't care who they are, they will want to know who is your God. Because why? The fruit of the true followers of Jesus will be made manifest. Glory to God. Let's read. Glory to God. Now when the apostles which were at Jerusalem heard that Samaria has received the word of God, received the word of God. Well, receiving the word of God is one. If you have a coat and you don't put it on, how could I know? So what we need is laborers in the field who is putting on Christ in the full authority, the full armor of God, to display the true power of Jesus Christ in those places, in every place. Glory to God, that people don't have to look at the dark side. They will come straight to the light, because the light is made manifest. Let's continue to read. Glory to God. Who, when they were come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Ghost, for as yet he had not fallen on none of them, only that they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then laid their hands on them, and they received the Holy Ghost. And when Simon saw through the laying of hands of the apostles the Holy Ghost was given, he offered them money. But remember, Simon already accepted Jesus, hearing of the kingdom. Glory to God. Amen. All right, so you see that Simon already believed and baptized here, over here. Glory to God. 13, amen, Acts 8 and 13, then Simon himself believed also, and when he was baptized, he continued with Philip and wondered, beholding the miracles and signs which were done. Amen. So the point we're making that once we are a good expression of God, amen, the love of Christ, and we show forth the beauty of God, men and women are going to recognize the genuine, hallelujah, response and the genuineness of Christianity. They will see the difference in the behavior, the attitude, the patterns, the way we speak, the way we carry ourselves, the way we are reliable, hallelujah, the way we are honest, the way we do the things that is contrary to the world. And of course, the sign will allow men to come to Christ. So that's what we need in all the world, the expression of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory to God. As we live as Christian, to show them there is a difference. Glory to God. The kingdom, hallelujah, of God is at hand. So every one of us, we have an obligation to God to show forth the praises of Him who have called us from darkness to His marvelous light. So that's what we need in Haiti. We need people to go down and proclaim the gospel of Jesus with power and authority, that those in darkness may come to the marvelous light. And all over the world we need that. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you, brother. Let's keep praying for that nation. Let's keep empowering the people of Haiti and around the world, wherever they are.
You are God.
347-663-8638.
Holy.
And my brother, don't feel that you alone cannot make a difference. You can get in touch with somebody on the ground in Haiti, one or two good ministers, and stand in the gap with them and allow God to send His power, that they can go about and manifest the power of Jesus, that the nation will no longer want counterfeit power. They will want it from the source of all power. Glory to God. Yes, indeed.
You are Lord.
347-663-8638.
Declare that He is Lord.
Don't be shy this morning. Something on your mind?
God, you are Lord.
If you have not received Jesus as your Lord and Savior,
you,
we are here to tell you.
This is of your people.
Anytime you hear the voice of the Lord,
praise.
Harden not your heart.
You are,
could be in a song.
You are Lord. You,
a statement could be made.
Lord.
And the Lord can point you out.
Lord, holy and
those on the jobs, good morning to you.
want to talk to someone right now who's really at the end of your rope. You're tired, you're frustrated, and you really want to quit. But please hear me, you can't quit right now, because you're getting ready to step into one of the greatest seasons of your life. And if you quit now, you're going to miss the miracle. What you need is a breakthrough, and I know someone who can give it to you. Sing it, Donnie.
You are God and you are greater than anything.
And I worship.
And I worship you. You're bigger than life to me, Lord.
You are God.
You are God.
Sister Gloria, this one is for you. Good morning. I know you love this one. All right, indeed.
I want to talk to someone right now who's really at the
22 minutes after 8 is called Arise. Good morning.
You're frustrated and you really want to quit. But please hear me. You can't quit right now, because you're getting ready to step into one of the greatest seasons of your life. And if you quit now, you're going to miss the miracle. What you need is a breakthrough, and I know someone who can give it to you. Sing it, Donnie.
You are God and you are greater than anything.
And I worship.
And I worship you. You're bigger than life to me, Lord.
You are God.
You are God and you are greater than anything. And I worship you. You're bigger than life to me.
You are God.
You are God and you are greater than anything.
And I worship.
And I worship you. You're bigger than life to me. You are God and you are greater than anything.
And I worship.
And I worship you. You're bigger than life. You are my way through. My breakthrough.
You are my breakthrough.
You are my breakthrough.
Yes, you are.
My breakthrough.
You are my breakthrough.
You are my breakthrough, Lord. My breakthrough.
You are my breakthrough.
You are my breakthrough.
My breakthrough.
My breakthrough. Everybody say now.
You are God and you are greater than anything.
You are my.
And I worship you. You're bigger than life to me.
You are God.
You are God. You are greater than anything.
And I worship you.
And I worship you. You're bigger than life.
Oh, oh, my.
You are God. You are greater than anything.
And Lord, I worship you.
And I worship you. You're bigger than life to me.
Oh, Lord.
You are God. Yeah. You are.
Lord, I worship you.
And I worship you. You're bigger than life. You are my breakthrough.
You're my breakthrough, Lord.
Breakthrough.
Oh, yes.
You are my breakthrough.
My breakthrough.
Breakthrough.
Give me your time.
My breakthrough.
Breakthrough, Lord.
Breakthrough.
Give me
your time. My breakthrough.
Breakthrough.
Sister Linda.
You are the God.
You are
God. God.
Oh,
Lord God. My breakthrough. Thank you, Lord.
You are God.
Hey. Gave me victory.
Breakthrough.
Every chain that bound me.
You are God.
Hey.
My breakthrough.
Jesus.
You are
morning faith.
Give the life to me.
You are God and you are greater.
Oh, yes, you are.
And I worship you, your
King. Give the life to me now.
You are God and you are greater.
Oh, my God.
And I worship you, your King.
From depression,
yeah. Wherever you are right now, receive your breakthrough.
Breakthrough from depression, yeah. Breakthrough from private bondage.
Come on.
Through from depression, yeah. Breakthrough from private bondage.
Come on, receive it.
Breakthrough to victory, Lord. Oh Lord, you're my breakthrough.
Glory to God indeed. 29 minutes after 8 is Choice Radio in the morning time. Good morning, good morning, good morning. We greet you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And definitely it's a pleasure to be here with you as we bless God for a new day in the land of the living. Brethren, and sometimes we don't even know how to say thank you. But we have to say thank you all the time. Don't care what we feel like. God is on the throne. Amen. So we encourage you on your job, wherever you are this morning, as you step out. We bless God for you. Thank you for making Choice Radio your station to listen to. We thank God for Jesus. We are grateful and we appreciate what he has done and continue to do in our life. Amen. So we are here to encourage each other in the word of God.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of the Lord. There is power in the name of Yeshua to break every chain.
This is a Jacob morning. This is a Lorna morning.
There is power
in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
Power in the name of Jesus.
There is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. Break every chain.
Break every chain.
Yeah.
Break every chain.
Yeah. Yeah. Sing it again. There is power in the name of
Right there.
Break it up.
24 minutes after 8. Good morning. Everyone who loved the Lord this morning, good morning to you. All the elders, good morning. You've been there a long time. Keep running your race. Let's keep running for Jesus. And of course, we need the elders to be a good example.
Break it up.
For the young one in the church. Dress right, walk right, talk right. They're looking at you.
Break.
Come on.
Break it up.
My God. Break up all folly ground this morning for Jesus.
Break it up. Break.
My God, who's in authority. Walk right, live right, step right.
Break it up. Break.
You have a duty to the King, and He's going to hold you responsible.
Break it up. Break.
Believe it.
Break it up.
You have believed the report.
Break it up. Taxi drivers, those on the road. Good morning to you, my brothers and sisters. Good morning, good morning, good morning. As we encourage you in Christ Jesus. Anytime you hear His voice, could be in a song. Humble yourself before the Almighty God. Surrender wherever you are. And walk in new liberty. Walk in life. Be born again. Be washed in the blood of the Lamb. This is real thing we're talking about. It's not a gimmick. It's not a game. And every man have to defend his own life, his own soul, his own life. So don't look at people. Many times we look at people and say, oh, look at them, they're playing holy, or they think they're something. That's up to them. You have to answer to a holy God on the day of judgment. Did you look at man to decide your life, or did you look at God? Let's look at God this morning. Glory to God. All those who are going wrong, let them go wrong. But we are called to go right. We bless the Lord this morning.
In the name of the Lord.
1,000 shall fall on the right hand. 10,000 shall not come nigh thee.
Those chains of addiction, break it up.
Break up the addiction this morning, whatever addiction it is. Woman, drugs, whatever it is. Break it up this morning. And walk before your maker. Walk before your God.
In the name of the Lord.
Until the day appointed. Glory to God. He can do it. God can cleanse you. God can wash you. All you need to do is cry out. Glory to God.
Bring it up. Bring it up. Those chains and drugs. Bring it up.
My God. Brother Simon, morning to you.
Lord, there is power.
Oh,
those chains of addiction. Bring it up. Bring it up.
Open forum this morning. Joyce Radio, good morning to you, everybody. Everybody. Glory to God. Bless God for you this morning. The believer in Jesus. My God, let's take that caller. Caller, good morning. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Good morning, Minister Straker. How
praise
are you today?
Lord, praise the Lord. I'm feeling blessed.
Amen. To God be the glory. It's another beautiful day that He has made. Amen.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Amen. So, well, I just wanted to share, you know, something with the body of Christ this morning as I went into it, and it blessed my heart, you know, and whatever bless us, you know, God wants us to share, you know. So, I'm going to go from 1 Corinthians 6, and I'm going to take it up from verse 12, where I'm going in the, I'm in the King James Version, where it says, the believer's body or temple. All things are lawful unto me, but all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but I will not be brought under the power of any. Meat for the belly, and the belly for meat, but God shall destroy both it and them. Now the body is not for fornication, but for the Lord, and the Lord for the body. And God hath both raised up the Lord, and will also raise up us by his own power. Know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them the members of an harlot? God forbid. What? Know ye not that he which is joined to an harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh. But he said, he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit. Flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is without the body. But he that committed fornication sinneth against his own body. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? I just want to repeat this. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own, for ye are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. This is the reading of the word. God was already blessed. Amen. So this I just wanted to share today with the body of Christ, you know.
Glory to God. Glory, before you get off the phone, you know, as you call and read that scripture like this, you know, the Lord is speaking to my spirit here, is that there are people who will tend to choose what kind of gospel they want to listen based on the kind of lifestyle that they live in. But the Lord is saying his gospel is one. Nobody cannot hide from the truth. Wherever you want to get what you want to get, it doesn't take away the truth of the word of God. So even if people will heap to themselves teachers that make them feel comfortable in their own lifestyle, they are just fooling themselves, because the word of God is truth and you cannot run from the word of God. So don't care even if you don't like the what you hear on Choice Radio, because it's too gospel, it's too scripture, it's too Bible. You fooling your own self, because only the word of God you need to purge you and to make you ready for eternity. So if you try to hide from the word and heap to yourself teachers, heap to yourself DJs, heap to yourself whatever you feel you want to hear, you only fooling yourself.
Amen. That's right. You know, and even to add to what you say, and this morning I was just in my room, and, you know, you came to thought, and I'm saying, God, you know, I heard you speaking yesterday, and you were saying, you know, when you come on the radio, it's not to, you know, to you're not trying to break up the church or anything, but I just want to say that it's not about breaking up any church, you know, it's truth. And we human beings, we just don't want truth. You understand, as to whether in our homes or whatever, from the time you come out to tell somebody the truth is that they get offended and they feel they don't want to talk to you, they want to answer you anyhow. So I just want to say this, my brother, so long as you know that you are walking in the Spirit and you are living in the Spirit and God is leading you, you understand, to share, you continue to share without no apologies. You understand? So this is just, I want to share this morning and encourage you in the things of God and what God is calling you to, because we need truth, as the word say, when we listen to the word and we read the word and then meditate on the word, you know, we have to ask God, help us to live truth and to live right, because I heard you said this morning, this life, this is no joke. You hear, living for God is a serious thing. You know, sometimes we get caught up in, you know, the dance and the skip and whatever. Nothing is wrong, but at how about time you had to come to say, hey, this thing is more than that. Amen?
Amen. Well, the skipping and dancing, again, now we have to understand this. God wants us to be sober. So if you're not truly born again and you want to skip and dance and think that's Christianity, you're fooling yourself. You see, you skip and dance when you know you are liberated and you are walking in holiness. Then you skip and dance because you are safe in the sight of God and you are washed in the blood of the Lamb. Then you know what you're standing on. You're standing on the rock. When you're on the rock, you can rejoice in the Lord because he has delivered you from darkness into light. But to say you want to jump and skip and your life is not right, you fool in your own self. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
So there's a time and a place for everything, but the time and place is to rejoice in the Lord. When
in
you are
the Lord,
in
yes.
the Lord, you rejoice in the Lord. We can make a joyful Lord a noise unto the Lord when we are in the Lord, because we have seen his glory. We have seen his transforming power. We have experienced transformation in Christ. So now we jump in the Lord. We skip in the Lord. But if I'm just out there jumping, dancing, go to some church and you just jump in, dancing, hallelujah, and you not living right, you actually fooling your own self.
Amen.
You understand me?
Yes.
Glory to God. Bless the Lord. Thank you for the call.
My brother, you enjoy the rest of your day and continue to lift up the name of Jesus. Amen.
He's worthy to be praised. Thank you so much for the call.
Okay. Bye.
Glory to God indeed. Isaiah 53 says, who had believed our report, and whom is the arm of the Lord revealed? Glory to God, for he shall grow up before him a tender plant, and as a root out of the dry ground, he had no form or comeliness, and when he had seen him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows, acquainted with grief, and we hide as it were our faces from him. He was despised and we esteemed him not. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. So yeah, the word of God is what will set us free with Christ, and that's really what it's all about. That is why we have to walk in the liberty
where with Christ had made us free, Galatians 5:1. Amen. So when we are free from sin, from the world, then we have liberty in Christ. Now we can rejoice in the Lord. So it's very important for us to understand we cannot hide from the word of God. We don't heap to ourselves teachers who tell us what we want to hear, who make us feel good. Oh, I love to listen to that person because, oh, they just make me feel good and whatever. You can do all that. Nothing wrong with that. But the point is, we must have the word. We must have the solid foundation. We must be built on the rock. Otherwise, we deceive our own selves. So that's a very important this morning, my beloved sister, that we present our body a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto the Lord, according to the word of God in Romans. Amen. Glory to God. Romans 12:1. So the child of God, hallelujah, need to be thoroughly furnished with the word of God. Be born again for real. Hallelujah. Put on the new man for real and walk in the newness. Otherwise, you deceive your own self. The Bible said, light have come into the world. Men rather darkness more than light. Once we come to the light of the gospel of Jesus, God wants us to walk in it. Amen. And this morning we were speaking about putting on the new man. He wants you to put it on. It's real. It's an actuality. And I'm saying this to everybody. If you don't put on the new creation, it cannot work. You have to put it on. You have to get into the character of being a new creation, walking in the newness, practicing it every day, practicing it. Amen. You're going to fall sometime. You're going to get, you know, clobber over your head for trying to walk in the holiness. But God wants you to put it on. And the more you put it on is the more you feel better and comfortable. Then you find yourself and you find your groove. Glory to God. So then the world can't take you. And the devil will always have people come to you to tempt you to see if you are willing to say, I am on the side of the Lord. That's it. Don't come to me with that. I'm on the side of Jesus. Don't tell me that. Don't come with that. Don't talk that to me. I don't want to hear that no more. I'm not into that anymore. Don't come to me with that. I'm not going there anymore. Once you do that, the devil say, my God, she actually gone. He actually gone. That's it. We can't do it anymore. Glory to God. Amen. So it's a real walk. And that's why we were reading the scripture this morning, that we must put on that new man according to Ephesians 4:24. We have to put on the new man. Amen. Glory to God. If you don't put it on, you could never experience the glory of God. You could never experience the new man because you still have him off. You have to put him on. Amen. And like I said before, we will be tempted among our peers. The devil will send people who is your acquaintances, people who are closest to you and able to influence you, or able to look at you and probe you to see if you are really born again. Are you a new creation? Amen. Glory to God. We'll test you. Amen. So it's very important to put on the new man. We bless God for Jesus. The phone is open. It's an open forum this morning. We're going to get into a few scriptures just now, as we bless God for the caller and the callers and the listeners. Moreover, we bless God for you who have believed our report. Do you believe we are living in the last days? Are you making your calling an election show? Do you believe that Jesus is real? Do you believe he's coming back? Hallelujah. My God.
Lord, I lift your name on. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave.
I'm so glad you're in my life.
This is the Michelle morning.
I'm so glad you came to save us.
You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my dear. You paid from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the grave.
Glory to God this morning. Bless God indeed. Hallelujah. It's called Arise on Choice Radio, as we are here to encourage the saints of God to keep moving forward in Christ Jesus. Keep moving forward in purity, in newness of life. And like I said, the battle that we are going to face in this time are going to come from the closest to us. We'll test you to see if you're serious about this Jesus. If you are you serious, are you not going to stay? Are you going to stay away from this? Are you going to not do that anymore? Are you going to walk in that way? Are you serious? Come on, look at glory to God. So the child of God, we're going to face it in the last days. And the Bible tells us that if it is possible, even the elect will be deceived. That is to tell you how much the temptation will come upon the world in the last days, with all the seducing spirits, technology, and everything else to go along with it. Trust me, it's going to be a battle, brethren. And we need to gird up the loins of our mind and have a solid foundation in the word of God. This word shall not return unto the Lord void. Who have believed our report? Glory to God. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus. So we want to encourage the believers in Jesus. Let's be serious about the Lord. And let's put on the new man. And let's walk in the newness of life. You will be tested to see if you're serious about this Christianity. Are you truly born again? How you know? Glory to God. But we must make a distinction to the world. And like I said, the world is watching to know if you are truly born again. They're not going to tell you, but they know that they, wow, something has happened for real. And that is the mystery of the whole thing. Amen. You might think by trying to go along with the world, you are doing something for them, but you're doing something against them. Because if you know Christ, they want you to put on Christ, because they want to see Christ. Amen. Many people have not come to Jesus because people who claim to know Jesus have not portrayed him properly. Glory to God. The Bible said the Spirit of the Lord will draw men. Amen. Lift him up. You know, in whatever way we do, lift him up and he will draw men. Men will know the difference. They will know a distinction between either you're a Christian or not. Amen. So it's very important. So the devil loves when we don't put on Jesus and we are ashamed to declare, thus saith the Lord. Glory to God. Amen. As the young lady called and said, fornication. No fornicator shall inherit the kingdom of God. No fornicator shall inherit the kingdom of God. You don't have to believe it. You don't have to believe it. You could live and think God is going to play around. God is not playing around with it. You don't have to. Somebody doesn't have to believe it. But that's what the Bible says. No fornicator shall inherit the kingdom of God. None. Not even one. Glory to God. And to whom much is given, much more is required. God says once you know the truth, he expects you to walk in the light. There are people who don't want to put away their idols. They don't want to put away their old thing. They don't care. They think God loved me. Yes, he loves you. But even God say he going to give you strong delusion. If you hear the truth and you don't want to accept the truth, I'm going to give you a strong delusion to believe a lie. You want a lie? I'm going to give you a lie. And furthermore, I'm going to make you feel comfortable with a lie. Could you imagine this? Look at it here in the word of God. Amen. Galatians 6 and 19. Now the works of the flesh are manifest. They have come forward. They have presented themselves. They are illuminated. Here it is, glory to God, adultery, fornication, uncleanliness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, sedition, heresies, envy, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like. Of thee, which I tell you before, as I've also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. Unless if God is going to change his mind in the last minute and say, oh yeah, I just say that to scare you. We must believe the word of God, brethren. We must believe the word of God. Glory to God. So that's why we have to be born again. That then put on the new man. Amen. All right. Well, as we get to the 9 o'clock, take your Bible if you're there. We're going to look at a few scriptures today as we spoke of this putting on the new man and how important it is that we actually get activated. Amen. It's like buying a phone and you didn't have it activated. You already pay for the plan, but you didn't activate it. And they said, well, just go on the line and call, or you get a bank card. Came and they said, well, just call to activate it. Yeah, so you put it in the, you know, and activate it. It's the same thing. Same. You see, a lot of the things that we can relate to in the natural is also applicable in the spiritual. Same thing. God know the ways to deal with you. He know what we understand. He know what we understand. He know we not stupid. He know we understand stuff. You want to activate your bank card. You do this. You call the phone. You want to get your phone working. You go to the people. They press the button. Next. Next. Accept. Next. Next.
next. You understand? He knows. So the same way with Christianity, if you are born again, any man in Christ is a new creature. He said, well, okay, put on the new man. Amen. Glory to God. Father, we bless you and we thank you for your word, a lamp unto our feet and a guide unto our path, God. Father, we just thank you that you are God and you are God alone, Father. We thank you for every man, woman, boy or girl that is under the sound of our voice today in the name of Jesus. We humble before you as God, Father. Glory to God, and we lift you up. You said, if we lift you up, Father, you will draw all men unto you, God. And your heart is souls. You want men to know that you are God, and you are real, and you are true, and you love us. You are holy, and you want to save us. Glory to God from the wrath to come. Amen, Father God. So we thank you, Lord Jesus. Help us to look at your word. Amen. The perfect word of liberty. Amen. Glory to God. We're not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus. It's what? The power of God unto salvation. Amen. Glory to God. Bless God. And you know, yesterday we were talking about Nicodemus in John 3. And what we saw in that scripture, very important. Jesus never told him anything about his religion. But John had a religion. Amen. Nicodemus had a religion, sorry. Amen. He had a religion. He had his religion. What Jesus told him to be born again. Period. Put on everything you had. And we saw in Acts 2:38, the men were pricked in their heart because they came from all over the world with their basic different religions, but they were looking to God. So they came to the holy city, Jerusalem, looking for God, or looking to celebrate the Pentecost 50th with the people in Jerusalem. But they came with the various religions, scribes, Pharisees, and whatever. They came from different places in the world with their own practices and different things they have picked up from their forefathers. And he said, hey, guess what? You must repent. They understand repent means to turn back, turn away, remove, be new. Glory to God. And the Bible said those that believed, those that gladly. So there were people who was upset. Me, I have to give up all this. I have to put away all this. I have to get. Yes. Those that gladly receive, they received the word. They were born again. They were baptized in the name of Jesus. And then we understood they followed the apostles' doctrine and manner of fellowship. So what they did, they put away all the previous activities and they saw what the apostles did and they did it just the way the apostles did. They didn't add nothing else to it, no tradition, no nothing else to it. And that's why we see a distinction in so many different practices out there that makes us different from each other, because we have many things we have adopted from our forefathers, from tradition, from grandmother, grandfather. Oh, why are you doing this? Oh, well, somebody told me to do that, and that's the way they used to do it. Where is it in the Bible? Not one scripture tell you how about it, but people are still practicing it. So many people are deceived by what the devil is doing, and they are not looking at the scriptures, and the scripture is telling you, and the Bible tell you that God gave commandment to the apostles by means of the Holy Ghost. A matter of fact, he has promised that's the way he was going to do it. So they were waiting for the power from on high, but Jesus said them, I will give you. Let's just take a look there for a minute in Acts 1. Let's look at that. Very important here. Look at the scriptures. And everybody is aware that the church of Jesus Christ started in the book of Acts. So there were many churches before that. Amen. When I say churches, there were different groups of belief systems. Hallelujah. But the church, we had synagogue and temple and different things. But the church of Jesus started in the book of Acts, as we are well aware. It said here in Acts 1, the former treatise have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach. So Jesus, when he came on the scene, he began to do things and to teach things that is consistent with the kingdom of heaven. Glory to God, living out every tradition of man that was before preached. Listen to this. Until the day in which he was taken up, after that, he threw the Holy Ghost. Amen. He threw the Holy Ghost. He said, the Holy Ghost will lead us into all truth. So he threw the Holy Ghost, has given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen. Very important again, when we're looking at the body of Christ and we're looking at representation of the kingdom, they must carry and possess this authority. Amen. This power to be considered the apostles of Jesus. There are many people saying the apostles of Jesus. But Jesus said, those he have chosen, signs will follow them. So anybody who are chosen by God, we are bold to declare healing in the name of Jesus, laying hands on the sick, That is our thing. So the true believers in Jesus Christ, we believe in healings, we believe in miracles, we believe in speaking in tongues, we believe in all these things. That's the true followers of Jesus according to scripture. Glory to God. All right. Glory to God. So let's look in this here. We were talking this morning here about putting on the new man. And it's very important for us to understand putting on the new man. But before that, who had believed the report? That's important for us. Who had believed what God is saying? Who believed it? Who believed all the scriptures? Who really believed it? Who take it serious? Glory to God. Who take it serious? Very important for us to understand. Are we taking it serious? And we are meeting people today who is asking you, how can I be born again? Can I go back into my mother's womb? I met a young man recently. He asked me this. So we see everything is playing back over. Even many years ago, that happened with Jesus and Nicodemus. Man today are acting as if they don't understand. And they're telling you and they're asking and they're questioning you in the same way as Nicodemus. Could I go back into my mother? And they are serious. They're not joking. They are really confronting you today. So we tell you this word of God is true. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We bless God. Hallelujah. In John 12, and let's pick this up here. John 12. Glory to God. Amen. He said here in 12 and 38 that the sayings of Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled, which he spake, Lord, who had believed our report? And to whom had the arm of the Lord been revealed? Glory to God. Amen. Therefore, they could not believe because that Isaiah said again, he had blinded their eyes and hardened their heart that they should not see with their eyes nor understand with their heart and be converted. Amen. And I should heal them. Glory to God. So who believe? Amen. So what is important for us to be a believer, as we see the days approaching and we see things around us, we should believe the Bible. We should believe the Bible that we are living in challenging times. We are living in a different time. Amen. We should believe the Word of God. We should believe the Bible. Amen. Do you believe this morning? Are you a believer? Do you believe Jesus is coming again? Hallelujah. Are you making your calling an election sure? Glory to God. So this is what we need to do. So let's pick up this first scripture here in 2 Corinthians 5 and 17. A popular scripture here, always quoted on Choice Radio, because that is the power of God unto salvation. This is it. And this experience is something that you have to experience to really understand why all the excitement about Jesus, why all the talk about Jesus. Unless you have not come to that place, it's difficult for you to understand. You won't understand it. And the scripture has said it very clearly. Glory to God. Let us look at it here. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. 2 Corinthians 5. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Where should we pick this up? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's pick it up here at 16. He said, wherefore henceforth know we no man after the flesh. Know we no man after the flesh anymore. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Yet now henceforth know we him no more. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. So the scripture is saying they don't know this man anymore by the flesh. They can't recognize him. They see him, but it's not him. Glory. Let's read it again. Look at it. Wherefore henceforth know we no man after the flesh. Yea, though we have known Christ after the flesh, yet now henceforth know we him no more. You remember when Jesus was translated, amen, and again when Jesus rose, amen, he was walking on the road to Emmaus and they could not identify. Let's look at it. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Amen. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. So remember in this text, he's not saying any man in church or religion. He says any man in Christ. Very important. Very important. Look at it. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, Jesus is not making a statement that you can't understand. He's letting you understand Jesus Christ is the center of transformation. Amen. Glory to God. Receiving Jesus Christ is the center. coming to Jesus full circle is what makes the difference. Repenting of your sins, receiving Jesus, not receiving church, religion. I'm joining this one, I'm joining that one. But are you a follower of Jesus? Have you came through the door? The door is Jesus. You know, and as we speak about this, we pray in the name of Jesus that every listener will take this thing to heart. Take this thing serious, because sometimes you're hearing this and you're still just passing over it and thinking that, well, you exempt. I'm not talking about you. I'm not talking about your religion. I'm not talking about your group. I'm talking about every man. The criteria is to be born again, to be a new creation in Christ, not in religion, not in denomination, not I'm this, not I'm that. Is to be born again, knowing that you are in Christ Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's read the word of God again. 17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, underline this in your Bible. Maybe you want to do that. The emphasis is on Christ. Any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Amen. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. And all things are of God. Amen. Who had what? Reconciled us to who? Himself. So he has not reconciled us to religion, denomination, tradition. He has reconciled us to himself. Glory to God. Very important to see the scriptures in that kind of way, because that is really saying something very important here. And everyone will identify themselves in that and say, well, that's us. That's this group. No. The group is by the Spirit of God. Those who are in Christ are new creations in Christ, and they are one in Christ, in Jesus. They are all one together. Glory to God. They are not divided by anything else. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But they are in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So let's read this here. Let's continue this in 18. And all things are of God, who had reconciled us to himself by Jesus Christ, and had given us the what? Ministry of what? Reconciliation. Hallelujah. Glory to God. To wit, that God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself. Amen. Not imputing their trespasses unto them, and had committed unto us the word of reconciliation. Let's read. Now then, we are ambassadors of Christ. So I'm not representing my church, my religion, my bishop, my pastor, my tradition, where I came from. I was born in this. My father was that. My grandfather was that. No, no. No, brother. Glory to God, you're wrong. Let's read. Now then, we are ambassadors of Christ. Glory to God. As though God did beseech you by us, we pray you in Christ's stead, be ye reconciled to God. Hallelujah. For he had made him to be sin for us. Amen. Who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Glory to God. Let's pick this up over there in that popular verse we was in before. Let's go there and join this up together with Ephesians 4. Now we have learned of Jesus. We have heard the requirement of Jesus. And we're going to turn over to Ephesians 4 and see how we can actually put this thing on and get this thing to work, and to see the manifestation of what has been done for us, reconciling us to himself. Let's look at it here. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Bless the name of Jesus. My God. Where should we pick this up? All right. You know where we're going to pick this up? Glory to God. My goodness. We have to pick this up further than this. Glory to God. Let's go back to 4 and my goodness. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We're going to have to pick this up from the beginning. We have to just read Ephesians 4 from 1. Hallelujah. We have no choice. We have no choice. It's rich. Rich in all supplements. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It's rich, rich, rich. Let's read it. Therefore, the prisoner of the Lord beseech you that ye walk worthy of the vocation wherewith ye are called. Hallelujah. With all lowliness and meekness, with long suffering, forbearing one another in love, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as ye are called in one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, one baptism,
one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. But unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherewith he saith, when he ascend up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Now that he ascended, what is it but that he also descended first into the lower parts of the earth? He that descended is the same also that ascended up far above all heavens, that he might fill all things. And he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors, and some teachers. For what? For the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. Glory to God. Till we all come in the unity of the faith. Unity of the faith. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And of the knowledge of the Son of God, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, that we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine. And that's what happened with religions, and everybody have their own religion. I'm a this, I'm a that, you are that. We are tossed to and fro. It's one gospel, brethren. It's one Jesus. It's one Christ. It's one Lord. Look at it. Glory to God. Then we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of men and the cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive. They lie in wait to deceive. So if you are practicing anything that is not in the Bible, it's some man that tell you he learned it from his forefather or his grandmother, or that's the way they did it. You are wrong. You are following a wrong gospel. You are following a wrong Jesus. Jesus said everything is in the Word of God. Hallelujah. Everything comes from the apostles' doctrine. If it's not there, we can't practice it. You are sacrificing to devils. We have read that before in Corinthians. Let's read the Word of God. They lie in wait to deceive. They lie in wait to deceive. And again, about this deceiving, many people will deceive you not willingly. They also are ignorant because they took it from somebody else. Hallelujah. They love Jesus. Nothing wrong with that. They love Jesus. Yes, they love Jesus. They love God. But they are contrary concerning the doctrine of Jesus. And those things, we must pay attention to that. Glory to God. There are many people say, oh, well, let's just talk about Jesus. Jesus, he said, straight is the gate and narrow is the way. If we're talking about the gospel of Jesus, we must let the people know it's only one gospel. It's only one Jesus. It's only one Christ. Hallelujah. And even he has given commandment through the apostles. Glory to God. And we have all obligation to follow the apostles' doctrine and fellowship if we want to be saved. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Look at this. Glory to God. And we know the scripture tells us about deceiving and being deceived. Because the Bible tells us this, that if we are deceived, we can deceive other people. Not that we are willing to deceive them, but we already deceive. So we teach them what we know. But we are told to study to show ourselves approved unto who? God. Not religion. Not tradition. Not this group and that group. I'm a this. You are that. No. We must be of Jesus. Let's read. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's read in 15. But speaking the truth in love may grow up unto him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. Glory to God. Amen. From whom the whole body, fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, according to the what? Effectual working in the measure of every part, make it increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. This I say therefore and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their mind. In the vanity of their mind. They're doing their own vanity before God.
presenting their own sacrifice, making their own scheme, doing their own things. And they think they're doing it unto God. Everybody has their own culture of what we do with God. There's only one culture in Christ. Repent and turn to Jesus. One sacrifice has already been made for us. There is no more sacrifice for sin but to repent before God. So whatever practice we are doing that is not consistent with Scripture, we are sacrificing to idols. We are sacrificing to devils. This is what the Scripture say. Anything that we present before God as some formal whatever ritual, it's contrary to God of the Bible. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Look at it here. Let's read. This I say therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk, in the vanity of their mind, having the understanding darkened. Having the understanding darkened. Glory to God. So we could darken our understanding with tradition. Hallelujah. And culture and all this kind of stuff. That's where I came from. That's what we used to do. Yes. That's what you used to do before you met Jesus. Now you are told to repent and turn to the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. One sacrifice already made for us. We don't need to do nothing but present ourselves humble before God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So many are deceived, the Bible said. Look at it. Having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart. Oh, that's what my mother used to do. Oh, that's the way my grandfather was. Oh, there was an old man. That's what we... Oh, yeah. They are blind in their own heart. Deceive them. I thought this was religious. I thought this was God. No. Glory to God. Look at it here. Having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart. Hallelujah. Who being past feeling have given themselves over into lasciviousness, to walk all uncleanliness with greediness. But ye have not so learned Christ. You have not so learned Christ. Listen to this. If so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus, that ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that he put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Hallelujah. Not fake holiness. Because sometimes we could dress a certain way, and the way we dress, well, we look holy. We do all this. Oh, yeah. That's fake holiness. True holiness. Glory to God. And that he put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. Wherefore, putting away lying, speaking every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members of one of another. Glory to God. Be angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath. Neither give place to the devil. Hallelujah. Neither give place to the devil. Glory to God. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's continue this year. We're looking at putting on the new man. So it's important that we put on the new man, that the manifestation of the light of Christ will be experienced. Hallelujah. So the devil will tell you, oh, what you're trying to play? Oh, what you think you're better than anybody else over here? What you think? Why are you doing this? Your husband, your wife. Oh, you're playing so Mr. Holy Man now. Oh, so you're a man of God. Oh, yeah. What you trying to say? Yeah. The devil himself, glory to God, will come to anybody to try to make you feel that you don't know what you're talking about, or you've never been born again. Hallelujah. The devil will use anybody to come to you to test you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. But the Bible says we should put on the new man. Don't be afraid to put on Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Colossians 3. Let's pick this one up here. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We must pick this one up from 3 and 1. It's important for us. Glory to God as we look at the scripture. And remember what we're saying here for the body of Christ. The devil is real.
And if the devil know that you're going to put on Jesus, he will test you to see that you don't put it on, that you have a reason and excuse for not walking in holiness and godliness, not following the tradition of the world, not following man. Glory to God, he will test you. But you're not in style anymore. What happened? You're old woman now. You're old man now. Everybody's doing this. That is what's trending now. Glory to God. Look at it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Colossians 3. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above. Glory to God. Where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not of things on the earth. Glory to God. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. Hallelujah. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Glory to God. Do you hear what happened, the requirement here? Look at it. Set your affections on things above, not on things on the earth, for ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth: fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, covetousness, which is idolatry, for which things sake the wrath of God cometh on what? The children of disobedience. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. So the wrath of God come on the children of disobedience. Hallelujah. In thee which ye also walked sometime, when ye lived in them. Hallelujah. But now ye also put off all these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And many of us, we like to hear this all kind of foolish jokes. That's our favorite, man. Yeah. Yes. Like to listen to all kind of filthy communication. The devil will use anybody to defile anybody. Glory to God. The devil, no respecter of person. The same way with God. He will use anybody he get an opportunity to use to defile a multitude of people. Glory to God. That's why we have to walk in the Spirit and see if that Spirit is of God. Lifting up the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The integrity of the Word of God. Look at it here. Let's continue back here. Glory to God. Let's pick it up back in 5. Let's take it back in 5. Colossians 3 and 5. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth: fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is idolatry, for which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of men. You know, of disobedience. Now, you see this again. Any minister that make you want to be in this greed, and oh, God want to bless you and all the blessing, and every week you want to put into that, looking for that big house, looking for that car, looking for that money, looking for that, you are already deceived. You are already deceived. Glory to God. And once that's what they're preaching every week, that's what they're telling you. Oh, we already blessed. Yes, we know we're blessed. This is an inheritance for those who follow Jesus. That's why he says, seek first the kingdom. Seek first the kingdom, and all these things shall be added. Glory to God. You don't have to keep telling me about it all the time. Let's preach Jesus Christ and him crucified. Let's speak about holiness. Let's get people to be born again and washed in the blood. Let's get people to walk in the newness of life. Let's see the souls coming into Christ, and all these things shall be added. Glory to God. So don't come and seduce me every week about this. Oh yes, everybody bless. Everybody bless. No. This is not the gospel of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Tell your pastor to call me. Glory to God. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth: fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is idolatry. So any pastor preaching this covetousness, oh this and this, oh getting overflow, you're a liar from the pit of hell. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. For at which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience, in the which ye also walked some time when ye lived in them. But now, Hallelujah. Ye also put off all these anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds. We have put off the old man with his deeds. Glory to God. Yes, we're going to have struggles in areas, but we have put off the old man. Glory to God. We're not willfully doing these things again. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We have put off. Very important. We have put off the old man. And don't be afraid to put off the old man. And let the old man know, I put you off. Glory to God. You could say what you want about me. Glory to God. I've put off the old man. Let that devil know, I'm not ashamed to put off the old man. Or keep attempting to put off the old man. But we must walk in the newness of life. Don't let that devil fool you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. We must put on the new man. Let's read, brethren. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. 10. And have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of him that created him. Glory to God, which there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcised nor uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, bond nor free, but Christ in all and in all. Glory to God. So what we see here again, once we are in Christ, there is no more barbarian, there is no more Greek, there is no more Jew, there is no more Scythian, there is no more uncircumcision, there is no more, whatever, it doesn't make a difference. Once we are in Christ, there is no division. There is no division. So once we see all this different religion, that's not God, that's not Jesus, that's religion. Glory to God. Glory to God. Put on therefore, as the elect of God, holy and beloved bowels of mercies. Glory to God. Kindness, humbleness of mind, meekness, long-suffering, forbearing one another, and forgiving one another if any man have a quarrel against any, even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye. Glory to God. And above all these things, put on charity, which is the bond of perfectness. You hear that? Put on charity, which is the bond of, you understand me? Glory to God. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to thee which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatsoever ye do, in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God and the Father by him. Glory to God. We could stop it there for now. Bless the name of the Lord Jesus. But we see what this is talking about. Putting on the new man. We have to put on the new man. The child of God must put on the new man. How else would we see the power of God? How else would we experience the transformation if we don't put it on? If you buy a brand new jacket and it's cold and you don't put it on, how could you feel warm? Glory to God, you could still be freezing with a brand new jacket in your hand. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Romans 6. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Romans 6. Let's pick it up from 1. We could read this from 1. Hallelujah. Everything is rich. Every scripture is rich. Look at it. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? Come on. God forbid. God forbid. Hallelujah. If God has called us from darkness, how could we live in a sinful way? The Bible tells you God forbid. He won't do it. He won't allow it. He won't allow it. He won't allow it. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. He won't allow it. If we are born again, we are born again. And it's about time we need some men of God to preach the truth. Let people get right with God. Hallelujah. We need man of God to stop taking out of the Bible and putting what they want to make up their numbers. We need men of God to declare, thus said the Lord, that the nation can see a remnant of people that know God and is called according to his purpose. Come on. It's about time we get rid of you guys. Glory to God. Because God will expose all of you guys. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Look at it. Look at it here. Glory to God. He said, what shall we say then? That's the question. What shall we say then? Hallelujah. Shall we continue in sin that the grace of God be upon? Shall we continue? Glory to God. Is all of what you're saying, can you really tempt God to live contrary after he gave you his grace? Can you really rub it in his nose and tell him, I don't care, I'm still doing this, but I'm going to heaven anyway? Can we really do that with God and get away with it? Brethren, come on, brothers. Come on, we're serving God. We're talking about God, the King of Kings. He's a righteous God. Let us serve the King. Let us live for God. Let us live for God. Let the chip fall where it may. Let people say what they want. Let people criticize you. Well, so who cares? I'm going on to glory. This is what we're saying. We are making our calling and our election sure. Glory to God. Jesus said, if you stand up for me, I'm going to stand up for you. We must stand up for the truth. According to the word of God, 1 John and 1 to 2, we have an advocate with the Father if we sin. But shall we live in sin that the grace of God may abound? That is the question you have to find out this morning. Hallelujah. Can you live contrary to the word of God and hoping that the grace of God will abound? You're fooling yourself. You're deceived. Glory, let's read the word of God. Glory to God, Romans 6 and 1. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that the grace of God may abound? The Bible said, God forbid. Full stop. God forbid. How shall we that are dead in sin live any longer therein? Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? Do you understand this? Therefore we are buried with him by baptism unto death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in the newness of life. Hallelujah. For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in the likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, glory to God, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin, glory to God. For he that is dead is freed from sin, glory to God. Now if we be dead with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him, knowing that Christ, being raised from the dead, died no more. Death had no more dominion over him. For glory to God. For in that he died unto sin once. But in that he liveth unto God. Glory to God. Glory to God. So the word of God is telling us we must put on the new man that we can experience the glory of God. We must come clean with God, brethren. If we are born again, we must put it on. That devil will test you to see if you are serious. Are you serious? You no longer talk dirty jokes. You no longer listen to foolishness music. You no longer watch kind of movie. You no longer dress a certain way. Are you serious? Yes, I'm serious. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back. Glory to God, brethren. Glory to God. This is the call for the church. This is the call for the church. This is the call for the child, the bride in Christ, to rise up and represent Jesus. Otherwise, you won't make it. Otherwise, you can't make it. God won't lie. Can we forgive? Look at it. Hallelujah. Look at it, Romans 6. What shall we say then? Shall we continue? Glory to God, delivers the world. Hallelujah. That, oh, glory to God, that the grace may abound. Can we continue? Shall we continue, brethren? Glory to God. The Bible says, God forbid. Capital G. God forbid it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So what we're saying? We're saying we must put on the new man. Let them criticize you. Let them say you're strange. Let them say you're raw. Let them say you're boring. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let God be true and let every man be a liar, brethren.
If we have taken up this gospel, let us live for the Lord. Glory to God. Let us live for Jesus. You can't go wrong. You cannot go wrong with the Lord. But what he's saying, put on the new man. Put on the armor. Put on your garment. Put on holiness. Put on righteousness. Put it on. How will you know how it works if you don't put it on? Glory to God. Put on the light. How else could the world see? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God, brethren. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God, brethren. Hallelujah. So the devil will test you to see if you are willing to come out of this world and walk with Jesus. And I want to tell you, when you decide to put on Jesus, he would never lead you astray. He will never let you down. But you have to make a determination that I am turning away from this world and I am going to follow Jesus. Glory to God this morning. We bless God for Jesus. We have a few more scriptures we can take up for you this morning. We bless the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But this is the call and this is the cry of the Church of Jesus Christ in these last days. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let's pick up here. We could pick up this one here in Romans 12. We already read that one before. Hallelujah. But all the scriptures, line upon line and precept upon precept, God is saying the same thing all over the Bible. And as I say, and I beseech you, my brethren, the hardest thing in life is to start something. It's just like opening a business. It looks like it's so difficult. Or having an apartment. But the first day you have it, you say, oh, come on. I could have done this thing 20 years ago. You understand? And that's the reality. It always looked difficult to start to do something. But once you have started, you say, oh my God, I could have done this 20 years ago. I could have done this. Glory to God. So the devil, the tempter, will always come to challenge you. Glory to God. And make you believe, oh, you could never do this. I dare you to do it. Yeah. Say, devil, you watch me. Glory to God. You watch me. You watch me live for God. You watch me, devil. You watch me. Glory to God. You watch me, devil. Glory to God. You watch me. Watch me do it. Watch me do it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You watch me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Put on the new man. That is what we say. Put on the new man. Glory to God. Hallelujah. How else is going to work? Put on the new man. That is what the Bible is saying to us. Hallelujah. Romans 12 and 1. Very popular scripture. Every day we hear it. I beseech you. Glory to God. I beseech you. I beg you, brethren. Glory to God. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God. By the mercy of God. Oh, my goodness. That you present your body a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. God is saying, for what I did for you and for what Jesus have done for you, it is only reasonable. It is, you can't pay for this. It is only reasonable that you present your body. Present it, at least present it that we can use it. Present it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. As Abraham presented the sacrifice, his son, he presented, he offered it. Glory to God. And God told him, just offer it. I have a sacrifice already, but just offer it. Glory to God. Look at it. Glory to God. Present your body a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Don't sacrifice it, just present it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable, good, acceptable and perfect will of God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. What is the will of God? What is that perfect will of God? And the Bible wants us to prove it. See if what you and I are doing are lifting up Jesus. See if it's a good representation of holiness and godliness. See, prove it. Prove it. I saw an animation, a video that was made, and this harlot, she saw this other woman and she said, I'm a harlot like you. And the woman tell her, no, I'm a pastor wife. And she say, hey, you strange. That's not true. You are hallowed like me. You look just like me. She said, no. She show her Bible. She said, well, I have one too. My goodness. Look at this. Look at this hypocrisy. Glory to God. A harlot could not distinguish a pastor wife. Could you imagine? Glory to God. A harlot in the street. Look at the pastor wife and say, you a harlot like me. She said, oh, no, 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 no. I'm a pastor wife. The woman said, pastor wife, are you serious? You look just like me. She draw her Bible. The harlot draw her Bible too. Say, Bible for Bible. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, brethren, we got to get it right with God. We must get it right with God. If we are born again, we have to put on the new man in Christ. There must be a distinction between holiness and righteousness. There must be a difference. Otherwise, there is no difference. Glory to God. Any man in Christ is a new creature. Glory to God. Not religion. Not denomination. Christ. Glory to God. Any man in Christ is a new creature, the scripture say. Any man in Christ. In religion, you could do what you want. In denomination, you could do what you want. But in Christ, there must be transformation. There must be changes. There must be a revelation. Glory to God that I've been washed in the blood of the Lamb. Otherwise, you are fooling yourself. You are walking in the world. You are dark, as dark can be. Fooled by the devil. Making a mockery of God and His holiness. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Bible tells us in 1 Timothy 4. Now the Spirit speaks expressly that in latter times some shall depart from the faith. How? Giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Telling you can live anyhow you want and still follow God. It has to be a devil that tell you that. It must be a devil to tell you you can live anyhow and follow Jesus. Look at it. 1 Timothy 4. The Spirit speak expressly. Underline this in your Bible. Expressly. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Expressly. What a word. What a word. The Spirit speak expressly. Hallelujah. Glory to God. What a word. What a word, brethren. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God this morning. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Spirit speak expressly. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And we see the seduction in the world today. It is so tempting. And they are cutting all the pants the same way. They are cutting all the clothes the same way. So unless you don't decide to look. Look, really look seriously. For something that represents holiness or godliness. You will take anything and walk out with it. And all the name brand is up front. All that they want you to wear is up front. Up front on the shelf. Right before you. And everyone else is doing it. Why not? It's the fashion. It's the style. It's what's in. Yeah, you're right. Glory to God. Yes. Hallelujah. Now the Spirit speak expressly that in latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of the devil. It have to be a doctrine of the devil that we can live anyhow and claim to be walking with Jesus. It's a lie from the pit of hell. We must be born again and then put on the new man in Christ, that Christ can be made manifest wherever we go. Glory to God. The world will know we are different. Put on the new man today, brethren. Let us walk in the liberty where Christ had made us free. Don't be a slave to sin. Don't be a slave to the world. Let's walk in the newness of life.
Let us walk in Jesus, for God's sake. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He has sent his only begotten Son to redeem us to himself. Let us thank him. Let us walk in the newness. Let us walk in the truth of God. Let us be born again. Let us give him praise for what he has done for us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let us appreciate God this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The word of God declares here in John 15 and 1. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. And every branch in me that beareth not fruit is taken away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purgeth it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine. No more can ye except ye abide in me. I am the vine, ye are the branches. Ye that abide in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me ye can do nothing. If a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch, and is withered, and men gather them, and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what you will, and it shall be done unto you. Herein is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit, so shall ye be my disciples. Glory to God. As the Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my love. If you keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love. Glory to God. Even as I have kept my Father's commandment and abide in his own love. You know, as I read that scripture right there, not changing the topic, every time people talk about you love God, you keep his commandment, this is Jesus that is speaking. Jesus is the one that was sent from God to redeem mankind. And Jesus is saying to keep his commandments. What is Jesus' commandment? Love the Lord your God. Love your neighbor as yourself. And he have given more through the Holy Ghost to the apostles. And every time people read this, they come to this kind of religious thing that, oh, if you love me, keep my commandment and a commandment. Let's do it again. If this is Jesus, herein is my Father glorified. This is Jesus speaking. That he bear much fruit, so shall ye be my disciples. Who disciples? Not God disciples, Jesus disciples. Let's read. As the Father had loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my words. Glory to God. If ye keep my commandments, glory to God, ye shall abide in my love. Glory to God. Even as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Greater love had no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Ye are my friends if ye do whatsoever I command you. Henceforth I call you not servants, for the servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth. Another thing again, as you read the scripture, whatsoever I command you. There are many people that are going about and not receiving the Holy Ghost. They have just started religions. They have started groups. They have started whatever, they have started congregation without doing first things first. Repent and receive the Holy Ghost. They have not done that. They have not obeyed the word of God. So many people have not obeyed the gospel of Jesus Christ. Do what I command you. So many people don't believe in the Holy Ghost. Well, how can they be a disciple of Jesus? He say he's going to send the power of the Holy Ghost. How could they follow Jesus? They are not following the right spirit. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Glory to God. And he commanded them in the book of Acts to do not depart until you receive power from on high. And in the book of Acts 2 and 38, we were told by the apostles to repent and receive the Holy Ghost. But men are going along their own way. But there is a way that seems right unto a man. In the end thereof is the ways of death. Let us put on the new man. Let us receive Jesus as Lord and Savior. Let's be born again. Let's receive the Holy Spirit. And let's walk in the newness of life. Let's do exploits for the King of Glory. Let's call a dark world to the light of Christ. Glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Let no man look down on you because you are young, brethren. Let us live for Jesus. Let us live for the Lord. Let us put on Christ today. Glory to God. In front of your parents, in front of your husband, in front of your wife, in front of your family, in front of your community. Put on Jesus. Put on Christ. Glory to God. Don't be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus. Walk in the newness. How else could they know if they are not heard? How cool else could they hear of Jesus if we don't tell them? If we don't show them Christ, how could they experience Christ? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Will a man light a light and put it under a bushel? If we have the light of God, why do we hide it? Glory to God, whether in religion or whatever. Glory to God. Let us put on the light of Christ this morning. Glory to God. We bless God for Jesus. We bless God this morning. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Put our hands together. Yes, Lord. Yes.
All right. 5 more minutes to the top of the 10 o'clock.
Yes, Lord.
We bless God for each and every one of you this morning. We thank you so much for tuning in, and we encourage you, brethren, if you love Jesus, if you believe in the name of the Lord, if you want eternal life together with me who want it very bad,
yes, Lord.
Let's put on the new man. No more time for games. No more time for playing around with this world. Let's serve Jesus. Let's put on the new man. Let them know we are washed in the blood of the Lamb.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We say yes, Lord. Can I hear you say that? Yes, Lord. Let's say it. We say yes, Lord.
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 We have time for one or two more calls in the segment.
Yes, Lord.
We bless God for you. If there's a comment, something to share this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
As we present the gospel of Jesus and we bring it to you.
Yes, Lord.
Put your trust in no man.
Yes, Lord.
Trust this word of God.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
I'm trading my sorrows. I'm trading my shame. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
Amen.
I'm trading my sickness. I'm trading my pain. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
Yeah.
We say yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen.
Amen!
I press but not crushed, persecuted, not abandoned, struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for His promise will endure, and His joy is gonna be my strength.
Hey!
Oh, the sorrow may last for the night, the joy comes in the morning. I'm trading my sorrows. I'm trading my shame. I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord.
Yeah.
My God, my God.
I'm trading my sin.
Yes,
I'm
traded this morning. Who want to trade it this morning? Somebody in a taxi this morning, you want to trade it. You've had enough in this world. You want to make your call in an election show. You want to trust Jesus.
Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Amen. Let's sing that again. Sing yes, Lord.
Let's say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord.
We have time for one or two calls in the segment. We bless God before we shut it down.
Amen.
I want to thank everyone who have listened to this segment today. We have so much scriptures more to add on to this. But the word of God is clear. The gospel of Jesus Christ is clear. God is here for business. We're not here for joke. We're not here for entertainment. Many souls are lost. We got to rescue them from the pit of hell. Let's do exploits for the great King. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Amen. Let's sing that again. Sing yes, Lord.
Let's say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Amen. Let's sing that again. Sing yes, Lord.
Let's say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, Lord. Amen.
Struck down but not destroyed. I am blessed beyond the curse, for His promise will.
Hallelujah.
And His joy is gonna be my strength. Yeah.
For the sorrow that lasts for a night, the joy comes in the morning. I'm treating my sorrow.
Hope you enjoy your day today on the job. Good morning, everybody. Be proud to be a child of the King, brethren. Glory to God. You are washed in the blood of the Lamb. Why are you ashamed of Jesus? Why are you ashamed? My God. Acting like those that have no hope. Rise up for Christ, brethren. It's going to get real. Hallelujah. Say yes this morning, say yes. All the taxi drivers, good morning.
Thank you.
As we shut down the phone line, we thank you so much, everybody who have listened to the segment.
You must become as a little child. So let's just sing this out. Let's just lay our inhibitions aside, all our pride, our ego, and let's just let ourselves be free in our Father's presence. So let's just sing this out. Let's just lay our inhibitions aside, all our pride, our ego, and let's just let ourselves be free in our Father's presence. Ready? Let's sing.
La 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 la.
Hallelujah.
La 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 la.
Oh yes, a little stronger, baby.
La 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 la.
Who have believed the Holy Spirit? Isaiah 53:1. It's time to make the trade completely.
My shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my
shame. Those on the job, good morning. Wherever you are this morning, thank you for tuning in to Choice Radio. Activate yourself in Jesus. Glory to God. Let them know that you know who you are. Glory to God. Hallelujah. My God. My God.
is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and rich in love. The Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and rich in love. To all, and he has compassion, and all that he has made. And as far as he is, just from the west,
my God,
and that's how far.
Don't care what you have done, my brother. Don't care what you have done, my sister. Don't care how far you have gone from God. Once you're not ashamed to acknowledge your weakness before him. Glory to God.
He has removed our transgressions.
You can never know how great that salvation is.
Praise the Lord.
You gotta come taste and see that the Lord is good. I shouldn't just tell you. I cannot just tell you. I could just blah blah blah.
Praise the Lord.
When you give it all to him,
all my soul.
Trust me, he can make a difference in your life.
Praise the Lord.
I'm not talking about money and prosperity. I'm talking about the peace.
The Lord is gracious.
That passes all understanding. Glory to God. That we can see life for what it really is.
And
nothing bother you anymore. You let God have his way in your life. Until the day
that
he takes you with him. Glory to God.
Slow to anger and rich in love. And the Lord is good to all. And he has compassion on all that he has made. As far as he is, just from the west.
My God, my God.
As far as the east is from the west.
Hallelujah, Jesus. My God.
He has removed our transgressions.
I'm telling you this morning, 7 minutes after 10, if you have not received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and you would never understand what I'm talking about. You just won't get it like that. You have to come into the fold. You have to come into the faith. You have to come into Jesus. And I always say to people all the time, as much as everybody around you could be going wrong, you still have an obligation to God to go right. Don't look at people to determine if you're going to follow Jesus. Don't watch people who have failed in the faith and done things that is totally contrary to holiness and godliness to determine if you're going to follow Jesus. That has to be your individual call. Glory to God. It must be your individual call that I acknowledge I'm a sinner. I know I'm going to die. And I believe there is a heaven and hell. I was saying to a young man recently, I asked him, have you ever had any bad dreams? And he told me, yes. I say, so what you think it's all about? You in your bed at night and you see yourself in all these different places. How is that possible? You see, God is making sure that you understand that there is something more than just this life that we are living in. That's how loving he is. That's how great he is. That you will find out, what is dream all about? What is this about? Why was I? So you could know. The Bible said it's appointed unto man once to die, and then come the judgment. The Bible said there's a judgment after we have lived this life. Just as we have seen life in everything that we do, there is a cause and effect. Hallelujah. There is a prize for working hard. Hallelujah. There is a reward for doing this or doing that. The same way in this life, the Bible said, hallelujah, there is a judgment after this death. But brethren, God do not want us to be ignorant. Hallelujah. He had promised us eternal life. If we acknowledge our sin nature, hallelujah, and we turn and ask him for salvation, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who have died for us. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Bible says we can have hope in eternal life. Brethren, it's something to experience coming into the things of the Lord. Nobody can tell you. You need your own personal experience to know that God can change and God can save, God can deliver. Don't care what you have done in your life. Don't care how many abortions. Don't care how many divorces. Don't care how many robbery. Don't care what you have done. Any man in Christ is a new creature. It's something to behold. It's something to experience. The world can go along and keep talking about your past and keep trying to bring it up before you. Oh, you was that. Oh, you was that. Let them keep going on. But the Father, glory to God, He has promised to wash you in the blood of the Lamb. And this washing is something that you need to experience yourself. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You have to experience it. Nobody can tell you about this thing. You need to experience it yourself. Whether you grow up in church. Many times people say, I grew up in church. That don't mean nothing. That doesn't mean anything at all. Growing up in church doesn't mean that you know God. You have to receive Jesus when you become of age. That's why the criteria in Mark 16:16, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. It means you must be of age to say, yes, I'm a sinner. Yes, Jesus died for me. Yes, I want to be washed in the blood of the Lamb. That's why infant baptism is a waste of time. It's a lie from the devil. Glory to God. We must be born again as an adult. Glory to God. Acknowledging our sins before a holy God and asking Him to wash us with the blood of Jesus. That's why we encourage you. Let's get biblical, not religious. Glory to God. Amen. Let's get into the Word of God. Hallelujah. A lamp unto our feet and a guide unto our path. If you are out there today and you have not received Jesus the way I'm talking about it, you have not come to Christ as an adult and said, God, I have sinned against you. I know I'm a sinner. If I die right now, I don't know where I'm going. But I want you to forgive me of my sins. I want to be in heaven. I want to live forever. Glory to God. Hallelujah, brethren. This is the way out. That's the way to go. It's the only way, the way of the cross of Christ. Trust me. Come and taste and see that the Lord is good. And after you have received Jesus, you start walking in that new man. Let that devil know, I am washed. Glory to God. You must put on the new man. It's impossible to experience Christ on that level if you have not put on the new man. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. So I want you to say this prayer now and mean it from the bottom of your heart. If you are there, mommy, granny, you're on your bed, you're listening to the radio, let us go to God today. Let us go to God. Hallelujah. Let us go to God. Put away pride. Put away everything else. This is no time for that. Let us go to God. He is your Father. He is the one that truly loves you. He is your Creator. Let's tell Him we are sorry this morning for all we have done against Him. Let's go to Him now. And say this prayer with me and mean it from the depths of your heart. Mean it inside of you. With all of you today. Let's say it now. Dear God, I admit that I am a sinner and I need your forgiveness. I believe that Jesus Christ died in my place, paid the penalty for my sins. I am willing right now to turn from my sins and to accept Jesus Christ as my personal Savior and Lord. I commit myself to you and ask you to send the Holy Spirit into my life to fill me and to take control and to help me become the kind of person that you want me to be. And I thank you, Father, for loving me. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Glory to God. If you have said that prayer, you have just received Jesus as your Lord and Savior. With faith, believing as you have declared, confessing with your mouth, and believing with your heart. Now, Let's be obedient to God and seek water baptism, as Jesus himself was baptized by John in the river. And John made a statement and saying, you should be doing this to me. But Jesus told him, no, we must do this to fulfill all righteousness. Glory to God. So get baptized in water. Glory to God. Receive Jesus. Get baptized in water. Start reading your Bible. Whether you can read or not, go to the library. Ask somebody who you trust to help you to read. There is no pride in coming to God. There are many of us, we are good in one talent or the other, and we might not be good in another way. Nothing wrong with that. We could all learn something else and come into the fullness of God. So don't be prideful. Don't be, you know, ashamed that you cannot read. So what if you can't read? Amen. You maybe could bake a nice cake, but you just can't read. Amen. So what's wrong with that? Glory to God. We give God praise. We have life today in the land of the living. Amen. Glory to God. Don't let the devil stop you from knowing your Father in heaven. And once your heart is right with God, he's going to teach you the scriptures. He's going to let you know right and wrong. He's going to show you. He's going to show you by the Spirit who is false and what. He will show you. What a God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So ask God to lead you to a Bible-believing church. And for me, I highly recommend a church where there's no gimmicks and all this bunch of stuff, but Bible scripture is reading. It's the best thing to immerse yourself in the Word of God. The Word of God is a lamp, it's a light, it's a food. The more you feed on the Bible, there is a feeling that comes into you. A feeling, not feeling like feeling, you know. A feeling like a fooling up, a food that comes into your soul. I can't explain it to you. I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. But I know it's real. Yeah. The Word of God is real. So you read the Word of God, you get charged up like a battery. Glory to God. So get charged up in the Word of God. Find a Bible-believing church where you can grow and have root in God. Root in the Scriptures. Root in God. And then you continue your journey. Because the Bible said in the last days, I mean, he said, look, false apostles will come, false disciples, false preachers. He tell you they're going to come from every angle to deceive, even if it's the elect will deceive, you know. So we need to be grounded in the Word of God. Find a Bible-believing church where it's all about Scriptures. Very important for you to have a solid foundation in the Lord Jesus, according to the Scriptures. Amen. So we bless God for your life today. We thank everybody for listening to this program this morning. We bless God for you. And we always want us to let us understand, the only thing we have is the Scriptures. The only thing we have to work with is the Word of God. Glory to God. And we have a desire, and should have a desire, for the truth of the Word of God, that it can purge us, it can wash us, it can cleanse us, it can make us white as snow, once we are willing to humble to the Word of God and let the Word of God be preached to us. Amen. And then we put on the new man in Christ, that we can experience the fullness of God. The final scripture is taken from Galatians 5 and 16. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary one to the other. In other words, a lot of things that is fleshly, that we like to do just because we like it, culturally or whatever, it's just foolishness, the Bible is saying. It's all flesh. It's your desire. It's not God's desire. That's you want to do it. It looked good to you, so you like it. Your grandparents used to do it, so you want to continue with it. You want to continue the legacy. Yeah, the family legacy. But you're wrong. Let's read it again. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and ye shall not fulfill the lust of your flesh. Glory to God. Hallelujah. For the flesh lusteth against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh, and these are contrary one to the other, so that you cannot do the things that you would. But if ye be led of the Spirit, you are not under the law. And remember, under the law, there was rituals that was given. Under the law, there were stipulations that were lawful to be done unto God as a form of righteousness. Remember that, right? So once you are under, once you are in the Spirit, there is liberty in Christ. There's purity in Christ. There is truth in God. But under the law, you see that? You have to come with a ritual. You have to come with some kind of supplication. You have to come with something to present to God as a form of sacrifice, as a form of celebrating God. But that is contrary in the New Testament. Let's do it again. But if ye be led of the Spirit, ye are not under the law. There is no requirements for sin, but Jesus Christ crucified. Glory to God. Receive it. Walk in the newness. Hallelujah. Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulations, wrath, strife, sedition, heresy, envy, murder, drunkenness, all these things. Hallelujah. And such like. Of thee which I tell you before, as I've also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith. Faith in what? In the word of God. In what Jesus have commanded. Hallelujah. Faith, meekness, temperance. Against such, there is no law. There is no sacrifice. Glory to God. And they that are Christ, they have crucified the flesh. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. With the affections and lust. Amen. Glory to God. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not be desirous of vain glory. There are some things of vain glory. It's just a vain thing. It look good. It have a show about it. It look like it's holy. It look like something, but it's foolishness according to the scripture. It's vain glory, provoking one another, envying one another. Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one. Ye that have the word of God, ye that have the Bible, restore him back to the Bible stipulation, back to the apostles' doctrine, back to the truth of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Restore such a one. In a spirit of meekness, consider in thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear ye one another's burden, and so fulfill the law of Christ. And our burden is, if we see we are going contrary to the word of God, it should be a burden for me and a burden for anybody who understand the requirements of God according to the scripture. It is a burden if we see our brothers are going contrary to the word of God, because according to the scripture, we know they're not going to make it if they continue to walk after the flesh. Amen. Father, we thank you. We bless you for your word, a lamp unto our feet and a guide unto our path. We thank you for every leader, every pastor, every teacher, every bishop, any man that has taken the word of God to the lips, that we declare, thus said the Lord, that souls can be saved. Hallelujah. That the light of Christ may shine in this dark world, that men may see the glory of God in us and want to know who is our God. Father, we just thank you today. We bless you. We thank you for your spirit in the studio in such a strong and profound way. Hallelujah. We thank you for fulfilling what you have promised. You said you will never leave us nor forsake us. So Father, thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for being here with us. Thank you for continuing to help us to run this race that is set before us. We pray, God, that your spirit will go through all these airways, and those who love you and are called unto your purpose and call on by your name, God, they will rise up and do great exploits for the kingdom of heaven. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That souls can be saved and souls can come to know you, that you are the only true God and you love us so much. So Father, we bless you today in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Guys, be blessed of the Lord. At 12 o'clock today, we will be shutting down.
Thank you for
doing some repairs and stuff like that. So 12 o'clock, we'll be shutting down.
Respond to him with worship.
And then probably about 3 o'clock, 4, who knows.
Lord, you're so
around that time, we'll be able to be back. So we bless God for each and every one of you. Thank you so much, everybody. We bless God for you as we humble before you with the word of God. The word of God is real. Let's take God serious. Amen. God bless you, everybody. Hallelujah. Let's believe him. Let's walk in him. Amen. God bless you, brother.
Lord, we lift up holy hands and worship you. Thank you for your blood, Lord Jesus. Come on, that's right. Just respond to him with worship.
Lord, you're so holy, you're so holy. I see you hanging there. I see your nail-pierced hands. For me, you paid the price for me. I see your wounded side.
I hear your lonely cries for me. You paid the price for me. It was unfailing love, grace by your blood. Come and pour over me until all I see is your unfailing love. Your unfailing love, Lord. Oh. I see the crown of thorns. I hear the laugh and scorn. For me, you paid the price for me. I see your father's eyes. Turn from this bleeding son. For me, paid the price for me. It was unfailing love, grace by your blood. Come and pour over me till all I see your unfailing love. It was unfailing love, grace by your blood. Grace by your blood. Come and pour over me till all I see your unfailing love.
Love so amazing, so divine. Pour over us tonight, Lord. Let your love shower down in this place. Come on, cry out for his mercy. Cry out for his grace, Lord. We worship and adore you, Jesus. It was unfailing love, grace by your blood. Come and pour over me till all I see